See, I had a conversation with this girl today. She didn't really have a lot to say, but one thing she didn't shy away from was calling me out. She told me, why you sit there and speak from the comfort zone of your male privilege? People like me can go out and take those late night walks that you talk about, and most nights we don't know how the moon looks like. And it's not by choice, man. It's a controlled voice. She spoke about how it's 2021 and a woman is still being beaten by men, their husbands. And she spoke with a tired tone. She was tired from shoulder to bone. Because for how long? For how long does one have to fight? Look, she listened. She felt. She said her piece on a lot of things. But on the 16 days of activism, she spoke that what if perhaps what if on day 17, our loved ones wake up from their graves, bodies unbartered, necks untwisted, bullets reversed, killers jailed or in the ground where they took others, it would have been easier to understand these 2 weeks. Because instead we are digging more graves, graves stretching for as far as our solemn black eyes can see, names trailing behind hashtags. None of them ever named Lazarus. None of them ever waking up. None of them were coming home on day 17 and the chanting is softer. The human rights still not humane. The dead have multiplied. The mourners are fewer. And now it got me thinking. While I sit here, this laid by the Nile, the comfort zone of my mouth really right in this poem, having vivid. Need to listen, be accountable, take action against violating our women. Are they?